Welcome to My Yumi Room. My name is Kiara, and today I'm going to take you through my signature Totalbody Sculpt class. So Totalbody Sculpt is a mixture of Barre, Pilates, and yoga moves to guarantee you an effective and toning workout in only 30 minutes. For whoever of you who don't know me, I am the founder and director of B, Balanced Exercise and Mind, which is an iOS app that offers fitness and mindset customized program. Go check it out. For tonight's session, you won't need anything but your body weight and also a mat or a carpet that you're okay to sweat on to protect your joints in a section of the workout where we're going to go on the floor. If you need any modification or if you have any injuries, I'm going to say the modification as we go. Feel strong, you're going to try to push yourself tonight. So I want you to get in the middle of your mat and take a few rolls with your shoulders. So lift it up and roll it down and away from your ears. And again, inhale, exhale. You can face it up if you want to, or you can take this nice and slow just to bring the focus and the attention to your body. So I want you to invert the direction and find your breath as well. That's it. You guys, one more big roll, and then I want you to cross your knuckles together just in front of your chest and start lifting your legs up. This movement is going to help us to increase our heart rate as well as getting a little bit of movement into this joint, especially the hip flexors. If you've been sitting for a long time today, this works wonderful. We're going to add a little twist over that leg that you're lifting, waking up those oblique muscles as well. Hello guys, join us tonight. Nice. You guys, give me two more. Last one, press your arms above your head. Press it up, getting that heart pumping a little bit harder. Now to finish off here, we're gonna scoop it forward, reaching out for your toes, adding a little turnout within your head. And scoop, forming the C shape with the spine. We go four, go three, go two, go one, and walk down. And come down on the mat, becoming straight away into a half back. Palms directly under your shoulders, your knees directly under your hips. Tuck both toes under, and lift up your knees just to hover off the floor. Inhale, exhale, re-engage those abdominals. Now from here, we're gonna give me a little tiny tap with the pelvis and release. So a little tiny tap, release. As you release, make sure you're not arching the spine. It's just a simple little movement to get those abdominals going, especially in the lower part. They're a bit more lazy than the upper part, normally. That's it. Four more to go. Three more. Two more. Last one. We're gonna go into a little combo. We're gonna tap and tap both knees on the floor. You tap, tap your knees and lift. You tap and tap. You tap and tap. A little bit confusing, right? That's it. Hopefully not. And you guys, you give me three more of these. Two more of these. Last one. Hold it up and fully stretch this leg towards the back of the room. Coming to your high plank. Open up your chest. Draw your shoulder down and away from your ears. Engage the core, energize the back leg. That's it. Inhale, exhale. You hold it for four before we get this going. In three, in two, in one. You want to drop just your right knee down to the floor and lift. And your left knee and lift. Now both knees to the floor and lift like I did before. Down and lift. So you go right and lift. Left, lift, both, lift, both. You're gonna piece it up. Go right, go left, go both, and right, and left. Stay with me, you guys. Two more to go, two more rounds. Right and left, two and two. Right, left, two and two. You guys, you come down into your forearm plank. Elbows directly over your shoulders. Inhale, exhale, you come to a seesaw. So you push your body weight forward and back. Make sure you're not hiking or hiking your hips here. That's it. You're staying on the same level. You're going forward and back. You guys, four more of these. Three more. We're going to your side plank in two. Last one. And turn your right fingertips towards the left elbow. Open up towards the side. Stagger your hip and shoulder on top of each other. Open your arm up to the sky. Now, if you need to take a modification, drop down the bottom knee. Otherwise, hold it here. Give me a little lift with your hips. Lift and hold. Lift and hold. Lift and hold. We go in double tempo. Head, lift up, lift, lift. Little tiny pulses. Really pressing away from the floor. Engaging the side abdominals. Get them going. Four more. And three more. You got it. Two more. Last one. Hold it up at the top. Hold it, hold it. Four, four. Four, three. Four, two. You got this. Last one. Hand coming back to center. You're going to drop your knees. And let's see. You really need a rest. We can come to your child pose. Otherwise, we come back into your seesaw. So forward and back. Forward and back. You guys, nearly there. I know this plank set is always quite hard, but the plank is a great exercise to do at the beginning of the session to get every single part of your body going. You guys that were in the child pose, join us into your forearm. You guys that see swing, just stop in the middle. We're going to the other side. Left fingertips towards the right elbow. Open up, staggering hip and shoulder on top. Take in the modification if you need to. Otherwise, hold it here and lift and hold. Lift and hold. That's it. Lift hold. Lift hold. Really pressing the floor away. Lift hold. Now a little double tempo. Hold to that. Pop. 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 You guys, you're nearly there. You've got four. Two to stillness. Three. That's it. In two. You got it. In one. Hold it up at the top. You've got four. In three. In two. In one. Coming back to center. Last exercise. Last push. You want to lower one knee, lower the other. You run through those knees. We're going to finish off the set with a little cardio burst. You ready to go? Pace it up a little bit more. You guys, we're going to run those knees as fast as we can. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Run it. For 8, 7, 6. You've got it. 4, 3, 2, and 1. And toes together. Knees apart. Everybody comes into the well-deserved child pose. Stretch into the shoulders. Hope you're feeling warm now. Your warm-up is not over yet. You have two more exercises. Inhale, exhale, lift it up, and swing the legs towards the front. Next, we're going to come into your high toe now. So, we're going to take your heels nice and deep into the floor. And grab hold of the back of your thighs. Lift up from the crown of the head, nice and tall. And then as you inhale, exhale, and scoop those abdominals in, really finding a C shape in the spine. Inhale, exhale, just work through your breath. After the plank, you might feel out of breath, right? Well, you guys, I did it with you, so I'm totally with you here. Inhale, exhale, and scoop a little bit deeper. We're gonna get this position moving, and again, to maintain the C shape, the movement can only be very slow and very small. Inhale, exhale. You want to lower down for two, lift up for two. So you lower, two, you lift, two. You lower, two. Bring these heels into the floor to really feel the connection with the abdominals. And we're working a little bit on the upper part of your wall. That's it, two more. And lift up. And last one. Lift it up. We're gonna hold it. We're gonna drop and hold. Drop, hold. Maybe feel a little bit stronger. You can release one hand. Maybe you can release both. Maintain a C shape, you guys. Inhale, exhale, drop. Keep breathing. You don't want to do these movements in a hand. You don't. Your muscles need their oxygen. And drop, hold. Drop, hold. Become tiny little pulses. We love the pulses. You will find out and deep in this session. Really keep digging those heels onto the floor and hold it forward. Go three, go two, go one. Drop the hold to the back of your butt. Lift up one leg to take the top. If you lift up over the other. Inhale, exhale. Scoop a little bit deeper in that position. Release both hands. Inhale, exhale. Pressing the palm towards the floor. You want to feel like you are into water. So you want to feel resistance that you're pushing away. Squeeze the abdominals a little bit harder. Push it. And press it down. Press it down. Two more. Last one. And little tiny hundreds to finish up this set. Inhale. Exhale. Hold it here just for 10. For 9. For 8. For 7. In 6. In 5. In 4. In 3. In 2. In 1. And release. Straight away, you press your palm directly under your shoulder. You lift up your fingers off the floor. We come into your triceps. Nice job, guys. So, for your triceps dips, I want you to stretch your right leg nice and long. Your left foot is nice and flat onto the floor. Now, Now, as you lower down, you want to lift up the leg up towards the ceiling. Bend something from the elbows towards the back of the room. So it's not just, you know, like the hips going up and down. You bend something in the elbow and you lift it back up. Ready? Here we go together. Let's go down and left. So a little counter leg around here. That's it. Lower and left. You go four more. You go three more. Two more. Last one. Hold it down in the bottom. You go drop off. Drop. 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 That's it. Now to finish up on the side, you want to kick that leg towards your nose. And kick it, kick it, kick it. You go four, three to the change, two, one, and change it up. Right away, we stretch that leg, and lower, and lift. Lower, and lift. You go five, four, three. Keep bending, and opening the collarbones towards a high diagonal. Two, and last one, hold it here, drop hold, drop hold, drop hold. You're not kicking yet, in three, in two, in one, we're kicking in, and in, and in. We're getting ready for the reverse plank to finish off the set. For four, three, two, one. You guys can stretch one leg and join with the other. Pressing legs, high to stretch arms. Now, if you want to hold it here, go ahead. If you want a more advanced option, you're going to go tiny little bend press with your elbows. Bend push, bend push. You've got eight, go seven, six. Tiny little contraction. Three, two, one. And you guys release. Cross your legs. And third palm, you're gonna grab your shoulder blades. You're gonna find the stretch. Elongating those muscles after the isometric work. Oh, guys, that was a sweaty warm up, wasn't it? And release. Switching the other side. Inhale. Exhale. And shake it on four. Unravel yourself. Tap your toes under. And we're gonna get ready for your bicep. So before we do so, maybe grab your water bottle and have a sip of water. Nice job. Right, you guys. So, like I said, we're gonna get ready for your lunge. Now it's the first position for today. So I want you to come in the middle of the mat again and then step your right foot forward. Your left leg comes down on the mat. You wanna reach 90 degrees angle within both the legs, basically. Tap your left toes under and start with your hips for your shoulder down and back. Now lift up your back knee just to hover above the floor. We're gonna drop hold. Drop hold. Starting right with those pulses and the isometric contraction. Now guys, in each of that position, you should be able to take a little picture. So you wanna keep the movement nice and small, nice and short. That's it, drop hold. Drop hold. Keep the back knee as slow as you possibly can. Straight away engage the lower part of your abdomen. So now we're so fired up. And then also power the glutes. Yes. Even in the lunge, move to work. And drop hold. Drop hold. Now turn your drop and press. And press and press. Maybe press your palm in prior to start switching on also the last muscles in the back. Throw your shoulder down and back, away from your ears, and keep growing your speed as you carry your four more. Good three. Good two. Good one. We're gonna lift it up. Fully stretching both knees and then lowering. Two, one, and push it up. Three, two, one, lift it up. Three, two, one, and lift. So lowering three steps, tap the floor, lift it. Fully stretching the seams. We don't need to get those muscles up for the isometric. That's it, you guys. Feel strong. Feel the burn. Starting building up right in your thighs. That's it, last one. We go drop, drop. Drop and lift. We're going back to your drop hold. Drop and hold here. Drop hold. Nice and deep. Drop hold. Keep breathing. Four more. Good three more. Good two more. Last one. Now instead of pulsing, we're going to wrap the back knee in, switching on and firing out in those inner thighs. Wrapping and hold. Wrapping and hold. Grabbing and hold. You guys, see if you can drop a little bit lower. It looks like this, by the way. It's just a little movement. Grabbing and hold. Really engaging those abductors. In and hold. That's it. In and hold. In and hold. Almost there. Four more. You guys, three more. You're going to go into a full range. Single count. And two rock, so lift and lower. You rock and rock. You go lift, go lower and rock. Shake your arms up to high knee as well. Engage your whole body. Ooh, that's it. Select body for every single muscle. That's it. Nice job, guys. Two more. And you rock and rock. Last one and lift and lower and rock and rock. You guys, see what I feel? Knee a little lower. You guys, you send it back. I know. Those muscles are burning. We got three more to go. And go two more to go. Last one. You hold it up at the top. And drop a little lower. Your shoulders nice and low to your height. Inhale, exhale. You guys, you give me 10 pulses. And you're out. 10, 9, 8. Nice and deep. You want to almost touch the floor with the back knee. Go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And release, we're done. Go two legs. Sorry, so we're gonna get straight into the right. Right leg at the back, left leg at the front, both into 90 degrees, and you'll tap your right toes under. Keep your pressure coming directly in prayer, start with the other hands on your head. I don't mind, whatever feels better for you. You go drop hold, drop hold, drop hold. The back knee stays nice and close to the floor. That's why you start there. You got me. Four more. And three more. Two more. You guys, pulse it down. And really press your palms into one another to feel the connection with the back muscles too. It's so hard to work in the back cheek in a home environment, but we do what we can. That's it. You guys, six, five, four, three, two, one. You fully stretch. Have a tuck your lower down through. Two, tap the floor. Give it to that. Lower. Two, one. Doesn't need to be a hard tap. Just if your collar is just right. I just want you to go next to me. That's why I say tap. Lower. Two, one. Lift it up. Four more. Two, one. And lift. Your three. And last one. Lower. Two, one. And lift. Back to your drop hold. Drop hold. Now on this side, you might feel a little shaky sensation a little bit sooner because your legs start getting tired. That's exactly what you want. So don't be scared about it. That's it. Three more. Two more. Enjoy the bug. And we're going to move into the back. Switch it on to the inner thigh, inner thighs. That's it, guys. Inner hold. Inner hold. Get a tiny breath in. Wrap them again. Should we pace it up a little bit more? Let's do it on the beat. Breath in. Like I said, on the other side, it's just a small little movement. Really getting going in the muscle adductor. That's it. Nothing else. Go four. Go three. Ready for that full range combo. We go lift and lower two. Breath in and in. We go lift and lower. Breath in. For two. And lift. Lower. Get those arms going too. High knee. And lower, go in, and in. We go three more. That's it. In. Go two. You guys, I really hope you hear the music to keep you motivated to this. Give me one more, one more. Pull up, and in. You peel your front heel off, lower. Really spread your toes to give you a nice balance here on the ground. Switch on those abdominals up and lower. See if you can drop the back knee a little lower too. Woo! Feel the shake. That's it. Two more. And last one. Hold it up at the top. Now please stretch your arms into the height. See if you can drop an inch lower. 2 inches lower. Inhale. Exhale. Two final pulses. You're out. Engage everything you have to maintain the balance. Drop as low as you can. Really push yourself. Remind yourself the reason why you're tuning this evening. That's it, you guys. Go four, three, two, one. One more position. Knees down to the floor. One more position for your class, of course. So toes together, knees apart. We're going into a little bit of a fly dancing here. So I want you to lift up just 2 inches off your heels. So it's basically a fist. So once you are one fist up, I want you just to tuck your pelvis under and hold. Tuck and hold. Tuck and hold. Tuck and hold. Now a little bit faster, tuck. and tuck and tuck. So I'm feeling the spikes right away. It's a little party basically for this hip. Let's go. We're gonna start shaking it side to side. In 3, 2, 1, we're going to the right, the center, the left and center. Right and center, left and center. You got it. Woohoo! That's it. And right and center. We're gonna draw a little circle. We started to the right. And we throw it in your arms as well. That's it. It's a full body party. And invert the position. I know it burns, you guys. That's it. Invert the circle, other side. And you guys, we're gonna go right and left. Right and left. It's a proper party here. Woohoo! You guys, let it burn. 4 more. 3 more. 2 more. Last one, bring it back to the center, bang on the door with those arms and little tucks. 4, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're going to breathe. Now stay where you are, you can put a little stretch, pressing your right arm right behind you, and pressing your hips upwards. Nice big stretch for those hip flexors, for the quads, and switch over to the other side right away. And breathe, inhale, exhale. You guys, it's no time to waste. Instead of half an hour, you're 10 minutes out of your workout. Now grab your water, grab your feet, and then we get straight into that booty muscle. So, I want you to come into a clamshell position. We're gonna start with your elbows, hips, and heels in one same line, so nice and straight. Now, make sure you're not resting on the flesh part of your glutes here. We're not sunbathing. No matter in London, it's lovely. But oh well, we're gonna work your glutes here. We've done some bathing for the day. So, you guys, stay on the front, on the bone top, and start lifting your top knee up and lower down for 2 pounds. Here we go. And lift. 2 and lower. 2. And really engaging those glutes right away. You might feel your legs are gonna be shaking because you've just done your thighs, which is, you know, hard work. They're the largest muscle in your body. And some of them, they get here a little shaky. That's it. And single count, lift and lower. Lift and lower. You've got this. Keep your toes together. Make sure you're not rolling back. 4 more. 3 more. Your abdominals are always engaged. And last one. You lower down. Lift up the bottom shoe. You have diamond clamshell shape. We're going to lift and lower. Of course, if you have any injuries on your wrist, on your shoulders, you can come down and lay down into the floor. But I would advise to keep your up to engage your abdominals as well. If your neck becomes a little bit sore, you can always look down towards the floor to get the sore as well. That's it. 2 more. Last one. You're opening up to your rub back. Rub and rub. You want to imagine a sort of band or resistance around your body. You're working against it. Rub it back. Rub. Rub. Feel those abdominals and those glutes muscles which now are sore. 3, 2, 1. Lower down and free stretch the top leg. We're gonna lift and lower. Lift straight away in that full range. You wanna make sure you're not turning the sides, but you're keeping your body weight all to the front and your outer thighs only facing towards the floor. It doesn't matter if that leg doesn't come up as high. That's it. And 2 more. Last one, you hold it halfway, flex your foot and lift up. Lift up and hold. You don't pulse this little isometric contraction. Now, as your legs are becoming a little bit heavier, you perhaps have the tendency to sink through your shoulders. No, no, engage those abdominals, lift up nice and tall. That's it, nice and strong. That's it, 4 more. Your 3 more. Your 2 more. Last one, you hold it at the top and you give me a little bend push. Bend push. Imagine again a sort of resistance underneath the sole of your foot, and you push it away. Someone that you didn't like, and I push it away. Respect the distance it's made. COVID-19. 4 more. And 3 more. Your 2 more. So we're gonna get a little bit faster. Now, maintain this movement, maintain this speed. I want you to get your legs in a count to a 90 degrees angle right in front of you. You ready? 3, 2, 1, we got it. 8, 7, little small step, basically 4, in 3, in 2, in 1. Bring it back for 8, 7. Are you feeling it? Yes? Oh wow. Those glutes should be on fire after that. Nice and peachy. And we go again to the front. That's it. You guys go 6, go 5, in 4, in 3, in 2, in 1. Bring it back in 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You want to press onto your elbows. You want to lift yourself up. Now you want to swing your legs towards the front and then bring it back into starting position. So to the front and back. Front and back. You go 4 more. You got 3 more. You're certainly there, you guys. Do not give up now. And last one, you're gonna hold it here. Link up, reach the fingertips up towards the sky. See if you can lift a little higher. 10 final pulses. And lift. And lift as high as you possibly can, you guys. This is your last question on this side. Go 5, go 4, in 3, in 2, in 1. And you guys, release. Take a big stretch. And I'm getting this muscle before we go to the next side. Nice job, you guys. I can't see you, but I know that if you're still there at this point, it means that you're really committed. So well done for that. You guys, we're going to swap sides right away. Again, there's no time to waste today. And we're going to get, again, your heels, hips, and elbow in one line. You know the modification. You can drop down to the floor. And straight away, you lift up for 2, you lower for 2. Nice. Now, again, maintain the weight nice and forward. Bring to your flesh part, moving your body part. That's it. And lower for 2. Nice. Again, switch on the abdominals. Nice and strong, nice and engaged. And we're going to go single count. And lift, and lower. Lift, and lower. Maintain your toes together here. You've got 4 more to the chain. 3 more. 2 more. Last one, you lower down, you lift up just your butt machine. Again, don't pull the temptation to lean back. We're gonna lift up and lower single count straight away. Woohoo! That's it. Switch on the abdominals. Lift up nice and strong. You got 4 more here. Good, 3 more. Good, 2 more. Last one, hold it here, rock and hold. Remember what we said about the resistance around your thighs. You want to work against it. So the hand can come forward to keep you nice and balanced here. And rock and hold. Feel the shake, rock hold. I don't know if you can see me, but I'm shaking. I'm doing every single exercise with you guys to motivate you. So I hope you feel my energy from my living room to yours. 4 more. Go 3 more. Good, 2 more. Last one, you drop it down, you can stretch your top leg. You lift it up for 2 and lower. No, we can start lifting and lower. So you come lift and lower, lift and lower. That's what we did. And make sure again you're not sinking into your shoulders. You're nice and lifted, your abdominals are engaged. Keep it up, keep it up. You go 4 more here, 3 more into the change, 2 more. You're gonna go lift and hold. Ready? Hold just halfway. Lift hold. Lift hold. Lift hold. I've got the water bottle to motivate me now. That's it. Let's see if I keep it down. And lift hold. And lift hold. You guys, flex your foot and go to your bent press. Now, if you need to turn bend on your knee, huge press. We're energizing that leg. Four more here. The 3 more here. Lift away from the floor. 2 more. 1, and we're going to go a little bit faster. You have 8 counts until we go into the little tiny steps to bring your legs into 90 degrees angle. Ready? Let's go. We got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. That's the seat. Let's go. Bring it back. That's it. Keep it nice and tiny. 3, 2, 1, and 1 more. Woohoo! That's it. 3, 2, 1. Bring it back. Last one. Feel the burn. Embrace it. You guys, we're certainly there. 2, in 1. You want to lift up, really pressing into that elbow. You want to swing the leg to the front and bring it back. You want to point the foot and back. Point it back. Go for it. That's what I was saying about the water bottle. I'm going to drop my leg now. It's a good excuse, right? You should put yours on the knee. 2 more. Last one. Open it here and open your arms up for your tiny little pulses to finish. 10, 9, you lift the leg a little bit higher. Do it for me, do it for you. For four, for three, for two, for one. You guys repeat. Nice job. And get into the stretch. So your ankle right on top of your right knee. And gently push open that left knee. Just give it a little bit more of a stretch. Guys, with one more exercise before I let you go. My excuses, I gave you a long intro to tell you who I am and what I do. So here we are, you guys. Your last push for today. So I want you to stretch your legs and come into a sort of L position here. It's an abdominal exercise. I'm going to see now where you should do. So your feet are nice and flexed. You want to really press the back of the knee to the floor. Don't push your knuckle in front of you. Drop your shoulder down and back. Take an inhale, yourself through the crown of the head, and exhale, keeping your tailbone under, but keeping a nice long spine, it's nice C-shaped this one. That's it, and we're going to drop out. Drop out, straight away, switch on the top part of your abdominal muscles. That's it, and drop out. Drop out, you got it. Drop out, drop out, little pulses, here we go, 16 of them, and you drop, drop. Drop, squeeze the abdominals in, drop as low as you can until you feel the little quiver, the little shaky sensation. You don't want to be too low to not lose form, you don't want to be too high to not feel it. In three, in two, in one. Now hold it here, add a little twist to the right, bring it back to center, do the twist to the left, bring it back to center. Now if you feel like maybe you want to drop your right heel towards you and center, and then your left and center. Keep digging the heel onto the floor to really feel those obliques working. That's it. And center. And we're going to go right and center and left and center. Now hold it to the right and you're going to run towards the back. Got my dog sitting right on the corner. I don't know if you can see it here, but I'm just aiming for her. So aim for the back of the room and then drag the knee in as well. Little tiny pulses as you run. We go jump forward. In three, in two, in one, bring it back to center, other side, same thing. Just start with the breath, drop back, breath, back. We're aiming for the back of the room, and other little breathe here going on. Drag, 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 go just forward. Go three, go two, go one, bring it back to center, please stretch the side. Inhale, exhale, see if you can deep a little bit more into that position. Open up your heart in a high beat. Feel the little shaky sensation, embrace it. There's so much strength in that stillness, you guys. Even if it's shaky, we're gonna finish off with 10 pulses. 10 pulses and you're out. We're done with this workout. You ready? Pulse with me. We go down, down, down. Just for 8, or 7, in 6. Can you get a little lower? Go 5, in 4, in 3, in 2, in 1. And lower all the way down towards the floor. And hug your knees into your chest. Curl up into a little ball. And give your back muscles and your spine a little massage. Now hiding behind that lovely forehead bone. That's it. Now you want to bring both knees to the right hand side of your body. Head and shoulder to the left. Give a little spiral. Stretch here. Stretch your spiral muscles. Inhale. Exhale. And bring it all the way to the other side. Both knees together. Head and shoulder. Exhale, bring it back to center, and a little rock forward and back. Start nice and small, giving your spine again a nice massage. And then when you're ready, lift yourself all the way up and swing your legs towards the back. Now, you want to take the right leg in between your palms. Dip your hip flexors and thighs. And now stretch after the spine work. Inhale. Exhale, energize the back leg, tucking your toes under, pressing your left palm to the floor, and send your right elbow and your right heel towards the sky. We stretch the back knee, you guys, feel the stretch. Inhale. Exhale, now from here, drop down the back knee, and if you feel flexible enough, press. Try and aim to reach for your toes. If you can't reach your toes, that's totally fine. Here, keep the stretch here, pressing your hips towards the floor. If you're here, keep opening into the chest. Draw the heel as close as possible to the glute, featuring a fleshy part of the knee. Now on the top of your patella. And release. Bring it back into center and switch leg over. So we're going to the left. And energize the back leg. Tuck your toes under. Send your left elbow and then your fingertips up towards the sky. Fully stretch the back knee. Make sure your weight is nice and centered. Nice job, guys. 40 for 3, for 2, for 1. Drop your knees down. And again, if you feel flexible enough, grab hold of your toes and open up your chest. If you're not, that's totally fine to hold the position here. Press your hips down towards the floor. Inhale. Exhale. And bring it back to the center. Press your palm just directly under your shoulders. Tuck your toes under. Come up into a down dog position. Then find a stretch for those hamstrings, the back of your legs, the back muscles. And if this is too intense for you, maybe give it a little whoop. That's it. You guys breathe. Lift up the corner of your mouth as this is finished. Woo! You did it. You guys then soften both knees and then we'll both toes towards your palm. Grab a hold of the opposite elbows and putting your head nice and heavy between your biceps. You want to just release all the tension remaining into your upper body. Inhale. Exhale. Nice job, you guys. Release your elbows. One vertebra at a time. Roll up through the spine. Nice and slowly. You guys, inhale. Exhale. And again, take a deep last breath. Inhale. Press your palm above your head. Exhale. Draw it to your chest and bow yourself when we're done. You guys, I hope you enjoyed the workout. Let me know in the comments. And if you like this content, make sure you give a follow to Kiara Lewis. I see you guys there.